Good evening. In the last lecture, we have seen the introduction to binary trees and the types of binary tree. Today, we are going to study about binary tree representation techniques. We can represent a binary tree by using two methods. One is array representation and another is linked list representation. Now we'll see the first method to represent the binary tree, that is array representation. To represent any binary tree using array, we use the following steps. In step 1, we convert the given binary tree to the complete binary tree by adding empty nodes wherever it is necessary. Consider this is the given binary tree to you to represent it by array representation. Now to convert this binary tree, we must add empty nodes to node B towards left hand side as well as right hand side, and one node to the right side of node C. So after converting it to the complete binary tree, the complete binary tree looks like this, which consists of nodes and some empty nodes. In step 2, we give the index to each and every node, starting with the root node to the last node. Root node is indexed as 0. Its immediate children will be indexed as 1 and 2 and so on till the last node. In step 3, we calculate the size of the array from the complete binary tree. The formula to calculate the size of the array from the complete binary tree is size of the array equals to the number of nodes in the complete binary tree. In above complete binary tree, the number of total number of nodes are 7. That's why the size of the array is 7. Now we draw an array of above size and map the nodes to node values to their respective indices in an array. If you see in the above step number 2, A is having index 0. It means it must be mapped in an array at index number 0. Then B will be mapped to 1, C will be mapped to 2, and D will be mapped to 5. Rest of the indices like 3, 4, and 6 will be kept empty. So if you see in this step number 4, A will be placed at B, A will be placed at index 0, B is placed at index 1, C is placed at index 2, D is placed at index 5, 3, 4 and 6th locations are empty, which are represented by the shaded area here. It means these memory blocks are gets wasted in the array representation. This is the drawback of array representation. Now we'll see the another method of representing a tree, that is linked list representation. In this representation, we use the node structure as shown in this figure. A node consists of three parts in this case. The first part is left child, a pointer to the left child. The middle part is information of the node. The right last part consists of a pointer to the right child. Where L child stores the address of the left child, where information stores the value of a node, R child stores the address of the right child. For example, this is the linked list representation of this given binary tree. Now if you see, A has left child, that is B, and C towards the right side. So there will be a pointer which pointing towards left hand side, and it is node B. There is another pointer which points to the right hand side at node C. If there is no left child and right child, we represent that part by null. Here C has only left child, but there is no right child. So the right child is represented by null. D do not have any left and right child. That's why it is represented by null in this part. So this is the linked list representation of the given binary tree. Thank you for watching this video.